All right, hi everybody. So let's start our new PegBoard game of fun. We're gonna go to Autodesk Inventor Professional 2015. There's either an icon here or go to Start and type in Inventor. Please do not hit uninstall. That would be very sad. So once you've double clicked it, it'll open up. The first time it'll take a while, but we're going to start a new part. And again, it might take a little time the first time you load it, but it will load. So this is kind of our starting screen. It doesn't know what we want to do, but we want to start a new sketch. So 2D sketch. Now it asks us, do we want to draw our part on like a table standing up or standing up on its side? So I want to do it like standing up. So if your piece was on the table looking up at you. All right, so I'm going to draw a square using this rectangle tool. So I'm just going to drag it. It doesn't matter how big, I just drag it, right? So this is kind of rectangle-ish, square-ish. I need to make it 4.5 inches by 4.5 inches. So I'm going to click on the dimension tool and I'm going to drag it out and type in 4.5. Now notice it got really, really big. And again, I'm still on the dimension tool. I'm going to click and drag and type in 4.5. Now you notice I have a perfect square, 4.5 inches by 4.5 inches. I'm going to finish sketch. And there it is. Notice it's at kind of an angle, but it doesn't have any shape yet, right? So let's give it some shape. We're going to extrude that shape out. And the piece of wood I'm giving you is, again, 4.5 by 4.5. And it's going to be 3/4 inch in depth or thickness. Right? So 3/4 of an inch. Click. And we're going to hit OK. So now we've got like a block of wood, right? There it is, so pretty, so shiny, ooh, oh, so pretty. Okay, so the next thing is we need to do a sketch. Again, we're going to do a sketch on our block of wood, just like you would with a pencil, right? We're going to pick right on our face, and we're going to make a triangle shape. So the best way we need, well, the best way to do it is we're going to lay out some kind of guidelines and build our triangle inside of that. So I'm going to play around. This is a new version, given that it's 2015. So I'm just kind of looking for something. Ah. Awkward. Okay, so I don't know where it is. I'm looking for a construction line. Now notice I use this find box and it instantly found what I want. So that's just a little trick. Whenever you're using a computer program you don't know, there's usually a find box and you type in what you want and it'll help you. Anyway, so I found what I'm looking for. I'm going to put down 4 points now. So 1, 2, 3, 4. All right, now notice I'm not measuring. I'm just placing them down in 4 corners, right? So from this corner, this very corner right here, to that point, it's going to be 1/2 inch. Now again, using this dimension tool here to make it exact, this corner, that point, 1/2 inch away. So 0.5. All right, now the same with these points. 1/2 inch away and 1/2 inch away. Perfect. Alright, so now I've got these lines, or these dots. We're going to put some lines on them because we're going to kind of, again, set it up to have our triangle inside. So I've got my lines. I'm going to go straight down. Now that is a straight line, and if you notice that your line just stuck like mine, you just hit escape. But again, I'm going to mark these all off. Bada bing. Bada bing. Just make sure your lines are straight and they're going straight across from your points. Alright, mine's a little funky, but. Okay, so now we're going to draw our triangle, essentially. Now, I'm just playing around with what the lines look like. You don't really need to worry about this. So, I'm going from that corner, and I'm finding the midpoint, right? You see this green dot? Dot! Right there. And from that corner, dot. So that should be the perfect triangle. And that was the purpose of these lines, is to get ourselves a perfect triangle. So now that we have our perfect triangle, let's clean this up a lot. There's a lot of extra lines that we don't need. So all I'm going to be doing is, well, before we do that, let's put these points. So on each corner of our triangle, we're going to put 1 point, 2 point, 3 point. Alright, so we've got our three. Now again, they're kind of hard to see because the cross and the cross. So again, let's clean up these lines. I'm just going to click on them and I'm going to press delete on my keyboard. Now if they're kind of giving you trouble, you might have to delete something else. But I'm just clicking and pressing delete on my keyboard. So they all disappear. Delete that. Delete that. I'll get you. Alakazoo. Making it look so fresh, so clean. Okay, there it is. There is our triangle. Perfect. Alright, so now we're going to use this rectangular pattern. Because we're going to take our 3 points and we're going to extend them along the triangle. So first step, I'm going to click on this point, and it's going to go along this direction. All right, I want it to go on that line, and it's going up. Notice it already put 1 point. We want 4 points total. Okay, and you hit OK, and look, it put those 4 points kind of along that line, exactly spaced at an inch away. So let's try it again. This point along this line, you can see the arrows going up, and we want 4 points. Awesome. So now we've got those laid out, we need to get this bottom line. So again, let's go to our rectangular pattern, and we're going to click on that point to go along this line. Oh, notice the direction's the wrong way. It put our point way offside our part. So let's flip it. And we want 4 points. Now notice, this one, look how close that is. That's because we don't want that inch spacing. I know from experience that it's going to be 0.875. I measured it out. Just trust me. I have a beard. Alright. So now we've got our external points all around the triangle. Let's put the points on the inside. So let's grab a point. And notice I'm lining up. Do you see that line that kind of, we call it snaps? It gets drawn down and boop. That's what we want. Now the other two are going to go boop. See those little lines? Awesome. Line it up. Boop. All right. So now we've got all our points lined up. These should all be very precise and make ourselves a really nice pegboard. Alright, so let's finish sketch. And that's what we got. It doesn't look like much, but it's laying everything out really well for our next step. Now we're going to put our holes through all of these points. And that was the purpose of these points. So bam, here we go. Alright, so we've got all these holes formed by magic. Now notice they're going all the way through, and that's not something we want. We don't want our pegs to fall through the board. So we're going to change the termination to distance. And we want it to go half an inch thick. So it won't go all the way through our board. Now the width of the holes, it's going to be a 5/16 inch hole. And those are just the drill bits that are going to be set up for you. So that is our holes. Notice they're not going all the way through. Perfect. So now we're going to change this generic kind of gray piece of square thing into a nice looking board. So it's going to look a little bit more accurate to what we're making. So I've changed it to wood oak. I'll change it again to oak's a little dark. Now you can't see the drop down for some reason. I don't know why. But again, it drops down and I've chosen birch. Alright, and that is our completed thing. Biggest thing is I'm going to save it. And look for your inventor folder. It should be right here. Now I've got several different versions from different classes. But I would save it as PegBoard. Nice spelling. PegBoard complete, right? If it's done, call it complete. And you're going to save it. And there you go. There is your completed PegBoard. Beautiful. All right. So the next video is going to teach you how to make the pegs and how to insert them. Thank you.